families compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board and every point is worth 50 rand. In round 3 and 4, the points are doubled and then tripled in round 5. The family with the most points at the end of round 5 play for a jackpot of 75,000 rand. South Africa, it's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for STEVE HARVEY.
Welcome to the show. Welcome to the show. Thank y'all. Thank y'all very much. I appreciate that. Thank y'all. Thank you, everybody. Well, welcome to Family Feud South Africa, everybody. I'm your man, STEVE HARVEY. Well, we've been back over here in South Africa for a few weeks now. Been enjoying myself, learning more about the culture, starting to get a handle on these names. We'll put a stop to that today, though, because I've been backstage practicing, and I still ain't got it right. We're gonna have a good time today. Hey, listen, folks, this is how the game works. We've had our researchers out on the streets of Nzamze. Now, we've been asking some answers to some very simple questions. These answers are locked in on the game board up here. All these families got to do is match them up. The family that matches up the most points at the end of the game will go on to have a chance to win some serious cash, the jackpot, 75,000 rand. If you're ready to get things going, everybody say yeah.
Yeah!
Give me Rocky, give me Bias Wesley. Kia Beswe.
Yes.
I got it.
Awesome.
I was rushing. I'm not gonna get yours, so.
Shori.
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 Ho.
Ri.
Ho. Ri.
Yeah.
Ho. Ri.
Yeah. There we go.
Wow, okay, my man, let's go. Got it. Surveyed 100 people. Top 6 answers on the board, here we go. What do couples always argue about on a road trip?
Directions.
Directions. Pass or play?
We're gonna play.
What do you do, sir?
I own a construction company.
Oh, good work. All right, I like. I used to work construction.
Oh, nice.
With my father. That was the first job not the first job, but that was a job I had in high school.
Nice.
I worked construction. Paper route was my first job. Pop bottle hustling was my second job. And then I cut grass for a company, and then I got into construction.
I took over from my father as well.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good, man. That's good. Well, introduce everybody.
Cool. Thank you, Malumi STEVE Thobela. With all my cousins over here.
Wait a minute, hold on. Say what you said again.
Thobela. It's a greeting, Gaspedi.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I got it. So go ahead now.
Yeah, cool. So I'm with my cousins over here, starting off with Toko, who's in the IT industry, followed by Nabjadi, who's also in the IT industry, and then Beacon, or as we like to call him, Bacon, Mr. Nice Time, who's in logistics, and last but certainly not least, Mr. Versace Jean, who is a service technician.
Okay, good. All right. Doko, what do couples always argue about on a road trip?
Money that they're going to spend.
Money! Lausadi.
Nabjadi.
Nabchadi.
Yes.
Okay. She's serious about her name. No playing with her. Nabchadi. Get yourself together, young man. What do couples always argue about on a road trip?
I would go with the choice of music.
The choice of music. Now, based on your name, I would assume, I'm just gonna take a guess, that you are probably the light of the family. You ready, man?
I'm ready, Augustine.
What do couples always argue with? Do you have a girlfriend?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Are you engaged?
No.
Oh, okay.
Just in a committed relationship.
You're in a committed relationship.
Yeah.
I like that, boy. I like that. And see, I love this a lot. I love this about this dude is he said, we're in a committed relationship without saying her name. That's what I like. Just in case it's two of them that think. Well, I love this boy. This boy right here. This is my man right here. But I'm sure you're happy with very nice. She's a nice girl.
She's super awesome.
Wow.
She makes me happy.
Oh, man. Oh, man, this is good. Oh, this is good, man. So how did you meet this wonderful girl?
Well, I used to gym a lot. So I used to run, exercise. Uh-huh. So this one time, she came to my house. She was visiting a housemate of mine. So I bumped into her on the hallway. I was like, hey, you, I see you. And she saw me, and the rest is history.
I see you. You see me? I see you, too. You see me, too? Okay, good, man. I like that. What do couples always argue about on a road trip?
I would say the number of days they're going to spend on the destination they're going to.
Good answer. Oh, the number of days.
Yeah.
The number of days. Only one strike. Gene.
That's correct.
Got easy. I got that part. What do you do, man?
I'm a service technician.
Service technician?
Yes.
Service technician.
I fix machines.
Oh, fix machines. Okay. What type of machines?
Cherry pickers, scissor lifts, boom lifts, those kind of machines.
Oh, okay.
Telehandlers.
Farming equipment.
No.
Well, you said a cherry.
Access for height. So if you need a machine to reach a certain
height, I know what you're talking about now. You know, like the phone company, the wires.
Yeah.
They get in the booth and they take you up.
Oh,
they cut cherry pick. I got you.
That's great.
All right, let's go. What do couples always argue about on a road trip?
How one person took a while to get ready.
Gene, that's every time you're waiting on your girl.
That's correct.
Wait on my wife a lot. I have learned, fellas, we never have an argument about waiting. I just go sit down until she get ready.
No.
Ain't no need of going in there talking about, no, hey, what, come on, we look at the clock, we're running late. Shut up. Go downstairs, sit down. When she get ready, she'll come down. Compliment her, tell her how beautiful she looks, and get in the car and go have a nice time. Anything else, you messing up your evening. Waiting on her to get ready. All right, we got two strikes now. We gotta be careful, man. The other family can steal. What do couples always argue about on a road trip?
Which snacks to pack?
What snacks to pack? All right, family, what do couples always argue about on a road trip?
The speed they're traveling at.
The speed! Number six. Four.
Restaurant.
Well, we got a game, folks. The MOHALA family, not on the board. The MASHIGO family, 59. Don't go away. We'll be right back from playing Family Feud. Back to Family Feud, everybody. The MOHALA family, not on the board, MASHIGO family, 59. Give me Doko, give me Pele. Okay, pronounce your name for me.
Pelang.
Pelang. I said Pelang. Pelang.
Yeah, okay. Pelang.
I said Pelang, my bad. We surveyed 100 people, got the top 7 answers on the board. Name something that would really annoy you in a cinema. Doko.
Somebody fighting.
Somebody fighting.
A kissing couple.
A kissing couple that bothers you?
Yeah.
Well, you mean what?
That's what?
Oh, you be mad because it ain't you? What are they kissing for? I wanted it to be me. He mad because the other people kissing and it ain't him.
The environment is not appropriate.
Play, pass or play. Pass or play.
We're gonna play. Let's go. Yeah, best friend.
Yes.
What do you do?
I'm a technician.
A technician.
Yeah.
All right. Have you introduced everybody to me for me?
I'll introduce them to you now.
Please do.
I'm Kiabetsi. I'm the big sister of the family.
Oh, you the boss.
Yeah.
And they know it.
Yeah.
They know it. Okay, let's go.
Okay, so these are my soldiers. This is the baby, the last one, mm-hmm. Pilang. He's responsible for some headaches in the family.
Yeah.
Refuses to take instructions from the elders.
Yes. Yes, beat him.
And then I have Eddie. The four of us are cousins with Eddie.
Mm-hmm.
Our dads are siblings.
Okay, yes.
Yeah, so Eddie is the beast.
You could have Eddie beat Pilang.
We could arrange that.
You could
that.
Work that out. Eddie could beat Eddie beat the hell out of Pilang.
So, yeah. And then I have Tswaragano.
What?
Tswaragano.
Tswaragano. Yeah. Tswaragano. What does that mean?
Working together, togetherness.
Unity.
Togetherness, unity.
I got unity, it. Okay, yeah. Cool.
It's a beautiful name.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, so Tswaragano comes after me. So, he's my handy guy around.
Mm-hmm.
Trust him with everything. Nothing gets thrown away until he gets a shot at it. Broken things, that is.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay, the last one is Khumutso.
What did you say his name?
Khumutso.
Khumutso.
Yeah.
Khumutso.
Yeah. There.
What? How?
Wanna know what it means?
KG. No, I wanna know why I spell like this. Khumutso. KG, that sound is ho.
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, I gotta remember. I've never
known. It's close to your favorite one, the K and the H.
The K and the H.
You mentioned it, yeah. Ha. You said you know that. You said you've got that,
yeah.
Right?
Ha.
So K and H would be K. So KG is H. Khumutso.
Got it.
Uh-huh. My man.
Khumutso.
Yeah.
Okay, good. All right.
It means comfort.
Comfort.
Yeah.
Unity, comfort, ass whooping. See, Eddie is English. Eddie is a hood name. I had a partner that was a pimp. His name was Eddie Velvet. He called himself Eddie Velvet. He was a pimp. Not for women, he just pimped the game. And Eddie would jump on you. For $2, Eddie would go to school and beat up anybody you wanted him to beat up.
Maybe it's in the name.
Yeah, it is. Eddie, name something that would really annoy you in a cinema.
People that can't stop talking.
Can't stop talking.
Yeah.
What do you do for a living, man?
I'm a local handyman.
Local handyman. Yeah, I got you. You work good with your hands.
Yeah.
That's a skill.
Yes.
You got to have people like that. That's what you do, man.
Yeah.
Some people gifted like that.
Yes.
Can fix anything.
That's me.
They don't throw away nothing until they give you a shot at it.
Yeah.
Then if you can't fix it...
That's me.
He can fix the washing machine. He can fix the toaster. He can fix the radio.
Even my necklace.
He can fix your necklace. He can fix your shoes. He can fix the toilet. He can fix the shower. Everything. He can fix your car. If he can't fix it, throw it away.
Yeah.
This is the man right here, baby. All right, now, name something that would really annoy you in the cinema.
I would say people who can't sit still.
People who can't sit still.
Yeah.
Keep walking. Oh, muscle.
That's right. Yeah.
Name something that would really annoy you in a cinema.
I would say, someone chewing out loud.
Do what?
Someone chewing out loud.
Chewing out loud.
Yeah.
Damn. Wait a minute. How they do it, man?
Yeah.
Don't close, food just falling out.
Yeah.
Chew, loud chewing. I have an uncle that when he eats, he just makes noises.
Turn down.
I'm just looking at him, man. I hate going over his house. I can say that because this won't air in the States.
Your secret's safe.
Yeah. All right, we don't have any strikes. We're rolling. Give me something that would really annoy you in a cinema.
Bad quality on the movie?
Yeah. A bad movie. Plang. One strike. Give me something that would really annoy you in a cinema.
Someone's phone constantly ringing.
Somebody's phone talking on the phone. Eddie, only one strike. Give me something that would really annoy you in a cinema.
You know, Steve, how you can't sit still for a long time. So someone behind you that's busy kicking your chair now and then.
Kicking your chair. Yeah, kicking the chair. Now, if you kick Eddie's chair, you're gonna have a problem. Hey, we got one strike. We only got one answer left. You can clear the board, man. Name something that would really annoy you in a cinema.
If you spill something on you.
If you spill something. All right, now we got two strikes. We gotta be careful. The other family can steal. Name something that would really annoy you in a cinema.
I'd say a crying baby.
My man.
A crying baby.
A crying baby. No, that was a good answer, man. That was a really good answer. All right, family, give me something that would really annoy you in the cinema.
Waiting too long for the movie to start.
Yeah. Waiting too long for the movie. Yeah. You have to wait on the movie to start over here? The movie is at 2:00. At 2:00, they turn the movie on. If you're not there, that's too bad.
All the ads.
You waiting on the movie to start. Number 5.
Freezing paintball.
Well, that's round 2, everybody. the MOHALA family, not on the board. MASHIGO family, 137. Don't go away. After the break, we're going to be playing for double the points. This is Family Feud, y'all. South Africa. Back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a good game. MOHALA family, not on the board. MASHIGO family, 137. Give me Napsade. Give me Eddie. Gotcha. All right, everybody, in this round, we doubled the points, surveyed 100 people, top six answers on the board. Name something you bend over to do. Eddie.
Six.
Sex. But it was the part, though. I pointed at him, and he grinned first.
Sex.
Lopsided.
Okay, I'm just gonna guess.
Okay, Eddie, pass the play.
We're gonna play.
Let's go. All right, T, give me something you do bend over to do.
Bend over to do.
Come on, y'all, I need y'all. Come on, let's. I need y'all. Now, we only got one strike. I want y'all to put your thinking caps on. This is a game of luck and guesses. Name something you bend over to do.
I'd say when I tie my shoelaces.
Now, you better believe it. Tie your shoe. The leader of the band.
Yeah.
The big sister,
that
the boss.
Be me.
Name something you bend over to do.
To pick up something.
To pick up something. Name something you bend over to do.
Cleaning.
Cleaning. Yeah. Eddie, tell me something you bend over to do.
To dig up. Vegetables.
To dig up.
To dig up vegetables, like potatoes and carrots.
Well, I know what you're saying. It's just. I just sent somebody to the store to get mine. I ain't been over and dug up a potato. Steve, you hungry? Yeah, I'm gonna go out back and dig up something. I'll be back. dig up some vegetables. All right, we got two strikes, man. We got to be careful. The other family can steal. Name something you bend over to do.
To do squats.
To do squats. I like that. To do squats. Kept it over here, man. That's a good job. See, I just gave him a little bit of encouragement. I just said, come on, y'all, just put your thinking caps on. They've been nailing it ever since. We got two strikes. The other family can steal. You got one answer left. You can clear the board. Gonna be a tough one, though. It's last one. Give me something you bend over to do.
I got this, Steve.
You got it?
I got it.
You got the last one?
I got it.
Wait a minute. Hold up, man. You're telling me that you know what number six is?
Yes.
And less than six people said it?
Don't do that, brother.
I'm gonna stand right here.
I believe it.
I ain't even going back over there. So come on, man. Name something you bend over to do.
When you play with a toddler.
What?
Playing with a toddler.
Play with a what?
With a toddler, with a baby. Playing with a baby.
Oh, playing with a baby.
Yes.
Oh, playing with a toddler.
Toddler, yes.
Oh, I know what the hell you was talking about. Playing with the baby, the toddler. All right, family, this is a hard one to get. Give me something you bend over to do.
When you're looking for something under a table or a
looking for something under the table. Number six. Well, that was round three, everybody. Mohalo family, not on the board. But Shiho family, they got 311. Well, don't go away, because after the break, we're going to double the points. You can still win it. Don't worry about it. We'll be right back, y'all. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Mohalo family, not on the board. Mashigo family, 311. Give me bacon, give me swaswagano. God, thank you, God. That was close enough. Point value is double. Top 100 people surveyed, top six answers. On the board. Here we go. If your love life was a movie, what genre would it be? Bacon.
Romantic.
Romantic.
Good answer, Ruth.
Comedy.
Romantic comedy.
Comedy. Let's go.
Laugh.
That was good, baby. That was good. I love you, man. All right, let's go, man. If your love life was a movie, what genre would it be?
It would be drama.
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 Yeah, drama. All right, big sis, we're gonna take care of some business. Now, let me ask you something.
Mm-hmm.
Are you married?
Yes, I am.
Oh, you're married?
Yes.
Oh, okay,
I'm going for, it's our 10th year.
10th year?
Yes.
Oh. Yeah. All right, let's go. If your love life was a movie, what genre would it be?
It would be an action movie.
An action movie. P, are you married?
No, I'm not.
No.
No.
How old are you again?
23.
23, yeah, you don't need to be married. Right? You're way too soon. I was married when I was 24. Mm. Yeah.
Would you advise it?
Would I advise it?
Mm-hmm.
Definitely not.
Okay.
No.
I'm with you there.
I shouldn't have been anybody's husband when I was 24. I wasn't ready for it. I just wasn't ready for it. And I paid dearly. All right, let's go, man. If your love life was a movie, what genre would it be?
It would be fiction.
Fiction. Yeah, baby. Unbelievable. Fiction. Eddie.
Steve.
Boy, this is gonna be a good one right here. All the answers you can really give are gone, so I wanna hear what you got to say now. Eddie, your love life was a movie. What genre would it be?
Thriller.
Boy, come on, Eddie. Thriller, baby. Are you married, Eddie?
Not yet.
Not yet. Ladies, if you're out there and you're looking for a thrill, tired of them boring relationships you've been in, tired of that ho-hum, dry relationship. Damn it, Eddie is a walking thriller movie. Ancient thriller. Michael Jackson, too. Thriller! My man. This is my dude right here. Let me tell you something. Usually in every family, I find my favorite. This is my dude right here. I can't say his name at all, but I love him. This is my dude. See, we would be friends because he can fix anything. Yeah. So T is silent. That's why I'm gonna call him T.
Okay. Okay.
If your love life was a movie, what genre would it be? There's only one left. Don't know what that is.
It's the only one left, horror.
It's the only one left, horror. Isn't it? It'd be horror.
Hey, dog, you my dude, man. Say it's the only one left. He had the number one answer when he said comedy. Then he came back and swept it off with horror. Well, it's the last round, everybody. Now, Mohalla family, with no points on the board, you cannot win the game. But you still have a chance to walk out of here with a bucket load of cash. So we've got to keep playing, because whatever points you have at the end of the game, we're gonna triple it, and we're gonna turn that into real money. So let's go. Give me Gene, give me Homoso. All right, fellas, in this round, the point values are triple. Surveyed 100 people. Top 5 answers are on the board. Give me a South African slang term or word for a young man or boy.
Lighty. Yeah.
Lighty. You gotta play. You gotta play. You gotta play. You gotta play. You gotta stack up points. You gotta play. All right, come on, y'all. Come on. Let's win some money here. Don't worry about the game. Let's get some money. Come on, let's go. Give me a South African slang term or word for a young man or boy?
A kid.
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 Kid. Kid. All right, only one strike. Doho.
Yes, sir.
Give me a South African slang term. Slang.
Yes.
You know, jive.
Yeah.
Talk.
Yeah.
That trash.
Uh-huh.
Smack.
Uh-huh.
So get at it now.
Yeah.
Or word for a young man or a boy.
Outie.
Oh. Outie. Outie. I can't help you because I don't know none. I don't know none. Now, we was back at the crib where I'm from, Cleveland. I know all of these. But we in South Africa. You're the boss of the family. You have a chance to save the young fellas. Give me, we got 2 strikes the other family can steal. Give me a South African slang term or word for a young man or boy.
Malume Steve, I'll go with Ndwana.
Yeah. Ndwana! Now we're talking. We gotta stay in there. See how she did that?
Mm.
The boss, slang term. Bacon, 2 strikes. We don't want to go over there. Give me a South African slang term or word for a young man or boy.
Boy, boy.
Boy, boy. Boy, boy. Hey, come here. Hey, boy, boy. Come, boy, boy. Family, here's the situation. You've won this game. But let me tell you something. If you get this one right here, we're gonna triple these points, let you still play for 75,000 rand. You can walk out of here with a whole lot of money. Now.
Yeah.
Now, you've got to know this answer. because you have, all of your siblings have been this.
They've been called it.
Yes, and worse. Give me a South African slang term, a word for a young man or boy.
Okay, in our hood, they call them small.
In the hood, they call them small. Well, let's look at the remaining answers. Number five. Four. Three. Well, I don't know how y'all did it, but somehow you messed around. You're not walking out of here empty-handed. It looked like it, but you didn't. You take away 10,050 Rand and a year's worth of KFC to the value of 10,000 Rand. Well done, and thanks to the folks at KFC. Good job, family. Happy you made some money. Hey, I need two of you. I need two of you. We're gonna play Fast Money. Jackpot, 75,000 Rand coming up. I got the brothers, they're about to do it. Let's go. Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The MASHIGO family won the game. And now it's time to play All right, Eddie, here's how Fast Money works. Your brother's off stage. He can't see or hear your answers. I'm gonna ask you five questions in 20 seconds. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. We have enough time, we'll get back to it. And then you and your brother come up with 200 points. Tell everybody what you're gonna win.
75 grand.
75,000 Rand. Yeah, all right, you ready?
I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name a place where you might sit on an adjustable chair.
Hospital.
Something that's unpleasant when it's blocked.
The road.
A job in the music industry.
Lighting.
Another word for weird. Something you eat that's red.
Tomato.
Yeah. Woo! Woo! All right, let's see how we did. All right, here we go. Name a place where you might sit on an adjustable chair. You said the hospital. Survey said something that's unpleasant when it's blocked. You said a road. Survey said. Okay, that was a good answer. I like that answer. A job in the music industry. You said lighting. Survey said. Okay, we're struggling a little bit here. Another word for weird. Past. You're gonna be all right. Something you eat that's red. You said tomato. Give us 180 points for this. Survey said. All right, there we go. We're all right. Come on. T?
Yes, sir.
Me and you, man, you my favorite, boy, but I got some. Your big brother just left. Now, it's gonna seem like he ain't been out here.
Impossible.
Yo.
Can't be.
It could happen. You could win this. But I need for you to give me every number one answer on that board. Yeah. And you still have a chance at 75,000 Rand. I'm not even gonna tell you how many points you need. And I'm not gonna tell you how many he got. I'm just gonna say, T, focus. Let's ask. Let's talk about it. Let's put our hearts and minds in this thing, and let's win this money, man. Come on, man. All right, let's go. I'm gonna ask you the same five questions. Ain't no way in the world you're gonna duplicate these answers. If you do, you'll hear this sound. You will never hear that sound. It's wide open. You can say damn near anything and you won't hear that sound. I'm gonna ask you for another answer. You give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time. We're gonna give you 25 seconds. Are you ready?
Ready, sir.
Let's remind everybody of Eddie's answer. Twenty-five seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name a place where you might sit on an adjustable chair.
Saloon.
Something that's unpleasant when it's blocked.
Drain.
A job in the music industry.
Pass.
Another word for weird.
Strange.
Something you eat that's red.
Meat.
A job in the music industry.
Guitarist.
Well, let's turn around and see how you did. To see his reaction when he saw what his brother did. But he big, you can't really say nothing. We need 174 points. Name a place where you might sit on an adjustable chair. You said a salon. Oh, that's a good answer. Survey said? Office. Office was number one. Something that's unpleasant when it's blocked. You said? The drain. Oh, that's a good one. Survey said. Nose. Nose was number one. A job in the music industry. You said. Guitarist. Survey said. Producer. Producer was the number one answer. Another word for weird. You said. Strange. Survey said. Yeah. Strange was the number one answer. Something you eat that is red, you said. Meat. Survey said. Strawberry. Strawberry was number one. Well, family, you scored 98 points. We're gonna add that to your earlier score. You're walking out of here with 38,950 rand. I'm Steve Harvey, everybody. We'll see you next time.